Hey everybody, it's your girl, Charlotte Van Horn with Locks Forever. And I just wanted to hop on here right quick and just to celebrate my anniversary. Yes, it is my anniversary today. Today is January 5th, 2020. And on January 5th, 2017, that was the last day that I worked at corporate America. And I am just so grateful and honored to say that I have not looked back. And so I just think that I need to commemorate every year that it's been since I was able to leave corporate America and just make, just document what I've done in that year, even if it's just for myself or just to encourage somebody else that is starting their own business, particularly natural hair business. And so let me just say that we really ramped up our Panama location this year. We were able to, upgrade it, decorate it, bring in the products. We are right now serving on a regular basis 10 people in Panama, which was my goal for the first year, and so that was great. I have been able to become a Panamanian resident. I started a podcast called Sisters Talking Natural Hair and Business, and that airs every Tuesday evening at 6 p.m., and I'll leave a link down there so you can join me and follow us, please. We've already done 11, and we have a really good following so far, I'm told by the producer. And so we're looking forward to expanding that even more this year. I've managed to retain and maintain 40 clients in the United States. And as I'm doing now, as my clients leave, move, or transition, I'm not replacing them. I have not taken on a new client in the United States since March of 2018. Praise God for just overflow. And I'm grateful that he has allowed me to work with several other women that I've mentored and coached, and some of them right in my shop, and then some of them outside, who I am more than happy to share the overflow of clients that come in. So don't stop calling, because I always will answer my phone, y'all. I had 3 speaking engagements this year, which was a goal of mine. I had a feasibility study done by Kimberly Bonner, and that was very interesting. I learned a lot about my management and business style. I learned the things that I might need to do if I ever decided that if I wanted to take the business into a franchise. And I think I'm a little bit too much like Chick-fil-A for a franchise, because I need to be able to control my brand, bottom line. And but I learned some very interesting things. And if you've ever wanted to consider a feasibility study for your business, I would highly recommend it. Let's see what else we did. We expanded our coaching services, and that has been interesting. And as I'm teaching other sisters how to get their sister locks business and natural hair businesses up and running, I'm learning from them as well. And it's just been a win-win. I'm so grateful just to be able to be a part of other sisters, operating excellent businesses. And I'm here for it. So I am absolutely continuing to accept clients for that as well. We created a group called Black Expats in Panama on Facebook. You can follow us there. We have a group and we have a page by the same name. And the page was basically created out of a need I felt that, when Black people go to different places, we look for different things. And I just found some of the other expat pages for Panama just didn't address a lot of the questions that we might have. So I decided, to just go ahead and create our own, and it's doing very well. We had our first meetup in December. We went to see Idania, the Queen of Jazz in Panama, and I want to say we had a turnout of about 15 people, and I was like shocked and happy. So we're going to be doing more meetups this year, but right now I got to get through our Sister Locked in Panama 2020 event, which we also started planning last year, and it is going down on January 17th. We are going to converge on Panama, Sister Locked in Panama. We actually went over the maximum that I wanted to bring, just one additional yes at a time, but it's going to be 43 of us on this trip. And we're going to do something different. We are going to honor the West Indian contributions to Panama. So we'll be going to the Samat Museum, which is a West Indian museum that basically deals with the West Indian contributions to Panama and the Panama Canal. Then we'll be going on to the actual locks, the Panama Canal. We will also be spending some time on a Virgin Island. So, apparently it was the island that filmed Panama Survivor, which I don't watch any of that, but we're going to do that. We're going to go to Casco Viejo, and I hope I didn't like totally mess that up. And it's going to be a great time. So everybody's really psyched and looking forward to it, and I look forward to pictures and catching y'all up on that once it actually takes place. I have recognized that I need to rest, and I am trying to do more of that to manage my time more effectively and to make sure that I'm listening to my body, because being in business for me is so exciting, and it makes me so happy that I can just work without really realizing that I'm tired. It's not the same kind of tired when you're working for yourself as it is when you're working for somebody else. Trust and believe. But you gotta still watch out and make sure you don't, you know, wear yourself down too much. We have mentored and helped at least 2, 4, 6 different women create their own businesses and actually flourish independent. And that's a big deal. I'm very happy about that. I've met again with Carol Marshall, and Carol Marshall was my last manager at Corporate America. And I always just think I gotta reach back, I gotta keep in touch, and you know, continue to honor and respect where I came from. And Carol is important to me because she was my manager, and she actually made it very possible for me to build my business the way that I did, because when I wanted to, there go that sun, y'all, oh my goodness. But when I wanted to build my business, I needed to start stepping down the time that I was spending in corporate. And she worked with me, and she allowed me to go part-time, and that was a big deal, and I will always honor her for that. My goodness, look at the sun shining in. Oh God. So anyway, let me wrap it up here. Oh, we did a product line expansion. We now have Hair Influence Plus, which was our first. We have Morning Glory. We have Yum Yum, which is a light leave-in conditioner. The Morning Glory is an everyday hair revitalizer. All of them have our special blend of essential oils. And then, of course, we have the No More Tender Heads. Which we actually are in the process of a trademark on that. We decided against the patent and just realized that the trademark would be sufficient. I think that I've grown spiritually, and I've connected back with God, because I've, you know, I don't go to church anymore, and but I'm very spiritual, and I just found that I could feel that was missing in my life. So I'm glad that this year, and actually I want to thank Alfred Street Baptist Church for that, because Pastor Wesley is my man. You know, I have just created and developed a YouTube relationship with him, and he has blessed my heart. And so that Alfred Street Baptist Church in Alexandria, Virginia is, you know, basically my church home at the moment, from afar, but I am contributing to the church because the sermons are blessing me, and it's such a nice church, and they do such wonderful things for the community. We have survived Alfredo's first full year of retirement, which is a big thing, because, you know, when you take that regular money from another, from your partner's income out of the mix, then it's really like where the rubber meets the road. And we have survived this first year, and we have not missed a bit, not a beat, I mean. And also, I back to Panama every 30 days. That's my schedule. I go to Panama every 30 days, and I'm just loving life. I've learned a lot about my management style this year, and I've made some adjustments to that. I've just learned a whole lot. My greatest challenge this year is Spanish, and I'm working really hard on my Spanish. That's the other thing that I'm working on. I had my first non-English speaking client, and her name is Maria, and Maria and I, we just love each other. And she has, because we want to be better friends, you know, she's working harder on her Spanish, and I'm working harder, I'm sorry, on her English, and I'm working harder on my Spanish. And we're gonna get it together. Maria is actually going to be on the trip with us at Sister Lock in Panama, and it was just a great challenge and a hurdle to overcome. So I think that is about my year in review, and I just want to say that I'm not looking back, I'm looking forward, and I'm looking forward to what 2020 holds. I think this is the year. Just you wait. I can't wait to do another update next year. I've really enjoyed having grandchildren this year and seeing our children flourish the way that they have with their husbands. It's a blessing. And I just want to say thank you to each and every one of my clients, to every person out there that shared a post, that told somebody about Locks Forever or what we were doing, that has just supported me with encouragement and love in any kind of way. I really do appreciate it. And I also want you to know that we will be hosting a Sisters Stepping Into Spring event the first weekend of spring this year. We are going to walk the Woodrow Wilson Bridge. And so when I get back from Panama, this trip, I will start working on that. But until then, I'm sorry it was a little bit long. But anyway, that's what I've been up to. Congratulations to me and Alfredo for seeing yet another year surviving in business. And our business this year is 8 years, y'all. 8 years in April, we will have been in this Locks Forever business. And if you've ever had a business, you know, of your own, you know how significant that is. It is a big deal, especially when you create a side hustle that allows you to quit your day job. What? That's what's up, you know. And also, I'm going to be working with some Afro-Panamanian organizations in Panama to help to train the natural hairstylist in Panama in customer service and business development. And just to be quite frank, so that they can compete with the foreigners who are truly coming. Foreigners like myself, you know, and it's all about giving back, you know. And so you reap what you sow. And I'm loving this reaping season. Love you guys. I'll see you online. Mwah. Thank you.